bikes reviews and tutorials video. It's a couple of years later, but I've done a video on how to get the brake pads and change them out on an X3 rear. And I'm through to the same stage now, but this time I also have to change the rotors out. So I'm going to show you the extra involved, and it's really, really small, the extra involved. So have a look at the video that's linked up above for all of the steps up to here. I made a good video, still very happy with it. So this guy here, we've taken and lifted out of place the brake pads and the caliper. What's left is the arms over the top. Now to get the rotor off, we do have to unbolt that. There are two bolts, if we can get enough light. One there and one there, okay? I'll give you the size. Those two need to come off. This arm will come off. And then the only other thing you need to do is to undo this. Now, don't be shy about your tool choice. On here, it's a 6mm Allen key is the size. I've had this soaking for a few hours with WD-40. These can be incredibly painful, and you do need something decent to get them out. This are 16mm. I'm going to use a socket for that. These are brakes, so they're all going to be tight. So you need a 16 to get those two off, and then that assembly will come off. And as I said, it's a 6mm Allen. Now, get something like this. This is an Allen key mounted in to a socket. I'll put links to these in the description. But don't muck around thinking you're going to get out with a hand Allen key or something like that. These are buggers. I've had to chisel them out. I've had all sorts of problems getting a socket like this and then using an impact wrench on it to get it out, and certainly soak it in WD-40 or, you know, CRC overnight to get them out as well. So this is a pretty new car. Obviously, the older the car, the more they stick. Yeah, get something decent like this. I'll put a link to a set of these. Absolutely brilliant to have for when you get stuck. Okay, so the two big 16mm bolts come out. You can see there's quite a bit of travel on them. They're quite long. This then caliper then drops away, comes off, and there's your rotor. And there is the little bolt, the little 6mm Allen head bolt. We get him out, and then that is now free. We get a hammer and give that a whack from behind and see if it'll come off while we're looking. This car's, I think, been near the sea. Quite a bit of rust. But that is all that's holding it on. When the caliper bracket's out, because the wheel nuts actually hold your brake rotor in place, all the tension and pressure of the wheel nuts, this is just a locating screw to hold it so it doesn't drop off or play up when you're changing your wheel. We're off. Had to upsize my hammer to a block hammer, but that's just because there's, as I said, there's a bit of rust on these, so it got a little bit stuck, particularly around here. So you can even put some WD-40 around where that ring goes on, you'll see. Lift this off. There's the hub, so we'll give that a bit of a clean up. You can see the rust in behind there. I have actually chosen ceramic pads for these. As I said, I'll put links to all the bits, to rotors, pads, the whole lot, because yeah, I reckon these are a good way to go. So putting it all back together, it really is just a matter of those two 16mm bolts, put them in and get them done up. They're going to be done up nice and tight. Remember, they're brakes, and then the little locating screw back for the hub. And you're done. For the steps of putting the pads and everything else back together to finish the job off, click on the link of the video that's right in front of your nose right now.